Assalamu alaikum. There is a special dua that we should try to memorize in this blessed month of Ramadan. In this dua, the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, Kalimatan khafifatan ala lisan, thaqilatan fil mizan, habibatan ila rahman. That there are two statements that are light on the tongue. They're heavy on the scales, and they are beloved to the Most Merciful. And they are Subhanallah wa bihamdihi wa Subhanallah al-Azim. Glory be to Allah, and to Him belongs all praise, and free is He from imperfection, the Almighty, the All Great. Brothers and sisters, saying Subhanallah wa bihamdihi wa Subhanallah al-Azim. Again, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi wa Subhanallah al-Azim. As you see, it's not really difficult to say, but it is something that is a tremendous reward on our scales. And we all need good deeds on our scales so that Allah accepts, so we can enter paradise. And also at the same time, it is beloved to the Most Merciful. And I think that in and of itself should be the real motivating factor, that we're fasting in the month of Ramadan to please Allah. And if these statements are pleasing to Him in the blessed month, in an action that He loves, Subhanallah, imagine all the reward that we can obtain. And just saying Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, just that statement in and of itself, a person saying that 100 times, the Prophet said that it eliminates all of his, specifically minor sins, even if they had reached to a scale or a level that was just overwhelming. Also, the Prophet, peace be upon him, said in a hadith that was narrated by Jabir, may Allah be pleased with him, where a person saying Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Allah plants a date palm tree for them in Jannah. So saying these statements in different amounts, saying these beloved statements to Allah, there's so much great reward. So let us strive to memorize it. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi wa Subhanallah al-Azim. May Allah accept. Ameen. And may Allah allow us and give us the strength to memorize this. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.